Hi, let us understand about arguments and environmental variables as a part of Dockerfile. Whenever I am creating an image, there will be a requirement not to hard code any value and pass that dynamically when I am building the image. As well as when the container is created, I want to pass or set an environmental variable so that the container as a whole or all the applications processes running within the container can access it. For that, we are going to use two type of verbs within the Dockerfile. One is argument, another one is env. Now let us quickly understand where argument will be used and where env will be used. Argument is nothing but the variable that I wanted to pass to the image while creating the image. That means once the image is built and the container when it is getting started, it will not have access to the argument. So the argument scope will be valid only when the image is getting built. After the image build is over, the argument, it cannot be accessed by the containers getting created from the image. And environmental variables are passed to the containers and it will have a default value. And if I want to override, I can override when I'm creating the containers. That means I can have different containers with different environmental variables. Let's see a demo and have a quick understanding. Let me go ahead and create a dedicated folder for this demo. Let me get into the folder and I'm going to create a test file for understanding purpose. Now let me go ahead and create a Docker file. I'm going to have the Docker file created from Alpine. I'm going to have an environmental variable which will have a default value as prod and it will be in the format of key value pair. So I'll have env and I'm going to have an environmental variable app underscore environment where the default value is prod. And I'm going to get an argument. So this particular argument needs to be passed when I'm building the image. So now you will be in a position to understand how this particular arguments can be used. So basically arguments, once it is passed while building the image, I can use that as a variable across the Docker file. For example, I'm going to use the copy where this particular file copy test will get passed to this particular image within the directory and the directory name is a argument. So while building the image, I will pass this particular argument. I'll change the work directory to the root and I'll execute the shell command. It's a very simple image where I am going to use the environmental variable and the arguments. Let me save this Docker file and build the image. So while building, I need to pass the argument app underscore dir. Docker image build. Now I need to pass the build arguments. The name of the argument is app underscore dir. And the value I wanted to pass is app underscore dir underscore arg. So this particular folder will get created and within that the file will get copied. I want to tag the image as arg underscore env 1.0. The name of the Docker file, arg underscore env, and it is available in this current directory. When I say run echo this particular argument, it is getting echoed over here and the file is getting copied by replacing this particular directory. I can create a container and get into the container and check whether the file got copied or not. Let me go ahead and check the image list. Docker image ls. Yes. Let me go ahead and inspect this particular image arg underscore env. Docker image inspect arg underscore env 1.0. Here I will be in a position to check the environmental variable. Yes, I do have over here. And I can grab the environmental variable and check the details. Let me go ahead and execute the inspect and I'll pipe it. Let me grab only the environmental variables. So I do have the environmental variable with the value as prod. Now let me start a container. So while starting the container, I need to set a new environmental variable if I want, otherwise it will be using the default one. So I can start a container, check the environmental variable as well as whether the argument utilized properly or not and the folder got created, I can verify. So let me start a container, Docker, container, run it in the interactive mode and remove the container once it is done. Now I'm going to pass the environmental variable. The name of the variable is app_environment, or to let me see unit test, and name of the container, and the image that I wanted to use is arg_env1.o. So I'm into the container. Let me go ahead and echo the environmental variable $app_. Yes, it is having the value unit test, and let me check the directory listing. Yes, I do have the directory that I provided as an argument. Let me get into the directory. The file should be available within the directory. Now let's start another container. So I am coming out of this particular container, and let me start another container without the environmental variable. So I'm starting another container. I'll be into the container. Let me echo the environmental variable and see the value. So it should have the default value that we provided as a part of the image. So in a quick summary, we had seen how to use the arguments and environmental variable and the difference between two. And this is going to provide huge dynamism in terms of creating the image as well as creating the container from the images, where I can use the arguments and variables wherever the value is going to be dynamic.